Hello everyone, today I'm gonna explain you cosplay. First of all, click my mouse click to open it. Then you simply click start route. Then you dive here out. Make sure to not take sharp corners. And you can just simply drive the course you want. So the first thing you have to do is just drive the course. So I'm gonna quickly dive a little course so you can see it works. So the orange is the course that you want. Then gonna stop here by a field. So then you press the square one on that one, yeah. Then we save it. We're gonna call it to field. Press enter. Now it's saved. Now you have to look in the maps. There you see it, to field. Then we go back. Press the X. Now we can set it up. We have to go back. We have to back it a little bit up. Now start the route. And he's on the way. And we're gonna see if he's gonna make it. And there he is. Finally, we took a little while. Now, next thing I'm gonna explain you is how to make it make a route for silencing. First of all, make sure there's enough space for the detectors to turn around. So don't make the route close to trees and stuff. First of all, start the route. Then you drive it, like you always do. Cosplay the first time. Then maybe in the beginning it will be a bit hard, but eventually you get there with learning how it works. Then you go into the silence clamp. Then make sure it tips the trailer. Then you have to go back to the field. Also make sure it doesn't take sharp corners like I said before. Because cosplay doesn't do corners so very well, so that's a bit disappointing. Make sure the beginning and the end point isn't too far from it. Make sure you save the route, so you can use other characters also. Yeah, I did a bit wrong with the saving. Now it's saved, now we're gonna look, emptying, so now we can try and set it up. Also you have to choose, or well, you can choose to do it manually, just as a combine, or or a harvester, but I prefer to set the right one to it. This you can choose, so it drives away with 0% in the trailer or 100%. For a combine, you have to make sure the auger is out. So then normally the first time you try the route, tractor will just first do one laps without going first to the combine, then it will go to the combine. So then you start her out. Now we see it passing, and we're gonna see if it tips in the silage clamp. And it doesn't tip, but it's because the tail is empty, so it doesn't tip. And here we are back. Normally the combine is also empty, so it will just turn around because it says the combine is empty. So this is problem. The next thing, we're gonna cart some grains to sell points. First of all, start with your grain point, then drive the grain to the grain sell point. Make sure to not take sharp edges, sharp corners, I mean, sorry. On a bridge, the orange dots will disappear, that's normal. So if you get that, it's normal, okay? Also, if there is a weight bridge on your map, the tractor will automatically stop with course play. So then there will flash a blue, then when you're at your sell point, you don't have to make a tip point. It will do automatically. Then you drive back to the farm. Here we are back on the farm. And then make sure the tail just goes back to the point where you take your grains. Like me, I have to drive backwards because I can't get to it by just throwing in front. So that's a bit difficult with course play. It doesn't drive so good backwards. So then stop the route, save the route, of course. Make sure you give it a name, that's also important. Then select the course, go back and make sure it's on transport mode. You can also adjust the speed. Then start road, it will fill the trailer automatically. Then it will start road and like I said, it will stop automatically here on a weight bridge, and like you see, it goes slower and it stops now. So, and it gets weight, then it moves farther automatically, so you don't have to do anything. It does this all automatically. And we are at the sell point, and now it's gonna get weight again. So, and there is a message. And move on. Then we can sell the grains. I didn't set a tipping point, but because it does it automatically. Let's take a screenshot. And now it will get weight again because there are two weight bridges. So and it arrives on, like you see. And we're gonna first of all, the last thing we're gonna check is how well it dives backwards. Like you see, it goes very slow, but it's also adjustable. You can also adjust the speed, how fast it goes on the way, in the field, turning speed, all the other stuff. So it is all adjustable. Like I see it now, it dives pretty good backwards. Better than me. And now it stops. So this was the video. Thank you for watching and bye.